what fellas good. You know what fellas good for the moolah.
Hamburgers. I love hamburgers. I eat them all the time. See ya.
My favorite food is a lot, but I especially like jibaritos, which is Puerto Rican dish, which is like plantain and meat and all that.
Ramen.
So, pizza or nachos.
Enchiladas.
Yeah.
Or enchiladas.
Nothing beats a Chicago hot dog. It's just unbeatable.
Well, I like to eat everything, so...
Sheila, eat you.
I like to eat a lot of Irish food and Scottish food, like haggis and blood sausage and fish and chips.
One of my favorite foods is tempura. It's a Japanese dish.
And I like German food and Polish food.
My favorite food to eat is pizza.
Like pierogies and knotwurst and cabbage.
Subway, because I pretty much eat that every day.
Empanadas and plantains.
Especially like being raised in like Venezuela and stuff, we eat like, my mom is really, like she makes really good Venezuelan food, she makes really good Pakistani food. The great thing about Chicago is that there's food from like everywhere. You can, if you're feeling like you want to have Greek food, there's Greektown. If you want to have Chinese food, you can go to Chinatown. If you want to, you know, have Italian food, you can go to Little Italy.
Okay, I didn't know anything about Barbados except the fact that it was an island in the Caribbean since before this class, and then I started learning things about Barbados. Like, I never knew that it was a country with a population of people who were, like, their ancestors were all slaves. I never knew anything about it.
Okay, I think it is very necessary that we know about it. I think about it probably more often than I should. And, you know, when a whole country is built on slavery, then you can't help but know about it. And so it is absolutely necessary that everybody knows what their origins are.
Well, yes and no. Yes, because Chicago's nickname is the Windy City. That's because, you know, the politicians like to be windbags and... But there are a lot of people who really don't care, and that's probably more of an American thing than just, like, really Chicago. Okay, by the way, windbags are politicians who just flap their jaws and don't actually do what they're gonna, like, what they say they're gonna do.
I think I can mostly relate with globalization because my family is originally from Pakistan. And I've been fortunate enough to visit there a lot. And whenever I go there, I feel like globalization is hitting the country more and more. Because whereas before, when I was young, I would never see any McDonald's there. And now there's like a whole bunch of McDonald's. Cultural country. This is the country where I can, you know, kind of relate to on a more cultural level. But it's like they're kind of steering more and more away from that. And, for example, I guess outsourcing would be, like, the best example. I guess another example would be, like, sweatshops and how, like, all these different... You get something from Nike over here. Complete abuse, and there's more cons to globalization than there are pros.
Hey, guys, it's me. About... $43,000 a year.
I've had a lot recently, like YouthLAB, there's all sorts of different ethnicities and religions here. And my brother-in-law, he's black, and at school, there's like every kind of person there imaginable, and like, so I've had like every kind of experience.
In personal experience at school, I don't think there is all too much racial interaction. And whatever the cause, I'm not sure. But by choice, I know that at lunch or in the hallways. I see mostly people separated in groups by ethnicity, and not necessarily because of ethnicity, but ethnicity. But no, I wouldn't say that there is too much.
Yeah, definitely. At my school, I see a lot of different races interacting. A lot of my friends are different ethnicities. Yeah, I just see it all the time. But there is sometimes a little bit of segregation. Sometimes people don't want to leave their comfort zone, and, you know, they kind of want to stay by the ethnicity that they were raised with.
I could talk about my school, for example. Like, there is racial integration, but because there's people from all different types of backgrounds and all walks of life, but it tends to be like you steer towards the people that you're most comfortable with, and you gravitate towards the people that are like you feel like you can relate to most. And the only time where like you really have to integrate is if you're making like a conscious effort to do so.
Under FBI investigation, U.S. Department of Justice, Census Bureau, as of 2005, whites made up 75% of the U.S. population, committed 69% of the U.S. crimes. African Americans make 12% of the U.S. population and committed 27% of the U.S. crimes.
Hi, my name is Marisol, and I love Chicago. One of the best things of Chicago is the lakefront and Harold Washington Library, which I spend lots of time there reading books, making research. It's amazing.
A wonderful place to live. It's pretty big. You can see just about any type of person, and you can live in this city forever and not have done everything that's here. I've been here 7 years and haven't done 75% of the things that's here.
I play drums in a ska band. I don't know if any of you like ska, but... Anywho.
In my free time, I like to skateboard, take pictures with friends, and go see movies.
I like to go out with my friends to Navy Pier, which is like a mall on the water, or go to the movies, or go to a buffet, because I love to eat. And... we love to go and play DDR, which is Dance Dance Revolution, which is a dancing game.
I like to read, I like to surf the net, and go to the movies.
For fun, I just go watch a lot of movies, play video games, hang out with people. That's about it.
I like to go to events like musical performances or just whatever's going on.
My free time is film or play baseball.
I like to watch movies. I like to read, and it, like during the summer, I like to go to Millennium Park and watch different sorts of things and hang out.
She's lying. With my she friends. Has no friends.
And what do I like to do? I like to write poetry. I like to watch poetry, and I'm really into music.
And I like to breathe poetry, and everything is poetry.
Good. good for the moolah.